here at the Montbello Library. This is a showcase piece now in terms of what we can do to save, not just save energy, but to save money and at the same time create a whole new industry. Coolerado Corporation, Mike Luby and the entire team, this is what makes great cities, is to have businesses that are on the cutting edge of innovation, that can find a business model and a need in society that they can fill at a lower cost and with better results than what was previously being done. I think now more than ever we see that these kinds of solutions that are based in sustainability go hand in hand with economic development. Companies like Coolerado are making us all healthier as well as our economy healthier. We would champion this kind of technology even if they were from Wyoming or Utah or New Mexico. But we're awful darn happy to have them here in Colorado.
A year ago, this firm directly employed 8 people. By the end of 2008, it doubled in size to a staff of 16. So far this year, it now has 28 employees and is projected to grow another 80 people over the next year. Truly, this is representative of the entrepreneurship that goes on in the city of Denver and really speaks to the opportunity around sustainability and the greening of our economy. Not only are they working here locally, but their opportunity includes both a national and an international market opportunity.
Mayor Hickenlooper has implemented some policies through Green Print Denver that have placed even more emphasis on energy efficiency and conservation. With that increased emphasis, as you might imagine, the city receives a good deal of, we'll call it input, about some of the latest, greatest, and greenest innovations in building, heating, and cooling. And as the mechanical engineer for the city, it affords me the opportunity to review most of these so-called innovations. But even better, I have the freedom to pursue the ones that show some promise. So about 2 years ago, a brochure landed on my desk about a brand new way to do evaporative cooling called Coolerado. Well, having spent about the first 15 years of my career in Arizona as a mechanical engineer, I figured I knew pretty much everything there was to know about direct and indirect vap cooling. So I quickly set to reading the information, thinking that I would quickly debunk their claims and appropriately file the brochure. Couldn't do that though. It kind of caught my attention, made some sense. I went to their website, got a little bit more in-depth information, and it was starting to make even more sense. I thought the theory was reasonable. Of course, being an engineer, they were going to have to show me. So I called the guys out of Coolerado up and was invited out to see their test demonstration. And it didn't take long. I was quickly convinced that the theory could be transferred to practical use. They had a setup there that made it really clear. It turned out that fire station number 11, historic fire station number 11, was looking at upgrading the air conditioning for their second-story dormitory from an existing standard swamp cooler or direct evap cooler to air conditioning. So I made the pitch that we could do way better with Coolerado than their existing swamp cooler system. We'd give them a lot drier and cooler air, and on top of that, we could avoid about $30,000 worth of cost to install the electrical service upgrade that would be required to allow them to install air conditioning. So they agreed. We put one on the roof to serve the second story dormitory, and on that first in that first August, I went out there on a 98 degree afternoon and measured temperatures inside of that dormitory at 74 degrees. Now you got to remember, this is an historic fire station number 11 with uninsulated brick walls, leaky casement single pane windows, and we're cooling the second story for less power than it takes to operate a standard hair dryer. Okay, I was pretty excited at that point. We've ended up from there, we've installed another one at that fire station. We've put a couple in at our street sign shop out at Roslyn. They've all performed very well. And so as soon as we saw the results at fire station 11, I started looking for a place where we could actually use it in a more commercial public setting. I found out that there was a plan to replace the existing air conditioning unit at this library, and it turns out that this library is an exact replica of Hamden Library, where we had recently done a replacement of the 30-ton air conditioning unit, and since I had done that job, I knew what this system was like, and I thought it lent itself very well to what we were trying to accomplish. You'll see a drain line off of the bottom of these units out there. The small percentage of excess water that drains out of the units has actually been run out to the trees north of the installation, so we're watering the trees with that. By the way, it comes up a lot, so I'll just tell you up front that, yes, Coolerado uses water to make cold air, but it uses no more water than an air conditioning unit doing the same job would use. Okay, so. Finally, since Hampton is a twin, Hampton Library is a twin to this building, after a year, we can have a direct comparison at the meter of the energy savings that we got by using Coolerado instead of air conditioning at two exactly identical libraries. The use of Coolerado instead of air conditioning is going to continue here at the city. We've already designed it in at the new Willis Case Golf Course Clubhouse. We've designed it into the upgrades at the City Park Greenhouse facility. We're using it to cool the gym at the Eisenhower Rec Center upgrade project. And I actually have a small project already in progress at Ocotlán Rec Center where we're going to replace the existing swamp coolers or evap coolers with Coolerado.
About 18 months ago, my wife Terry and I returned to Denver after a five-year absence, and we were glad to come back to be with family and be here, particularly since the last 5 years we were in San Antonio, Texas, where I was the president and CEO of USA Federal Savings Bank. But having retired from that, coming back to Denver, we were building a house in Wash Park. We wanted to build as green a house as possible. Solar panels and tankless water heaters and trying to be as light on the environment as we could. Well, architects that I was using told me about an innovative air conditioning company called Coolerado. And I said, well, I've never heard about it. What does it do? They said, well, they use very low energy and they use water to cool the air. And I said, well, it's a swamp cooler. I don't do swamp coolers. But I checked them out anyway and wanted to find out, well, okay, let's see what it's all about. I'll tell you, I was blown away by the technology, and I was equally impressed by the people. Dr. Mysasenko has an extraordinary background. He was a leading scientist in the Soviet Union. He's one of the leading thermodynamic scientists in the United States. He grew up in the Soviet Union under communism. He defected, got out of the Soviet Union, came to Denver, made this his home here. And without his theories and his science, none of this would be possible. We wouldn't have been able to create this revolutionary green technology.
But perhaps we can go ahead and flip the switch anyway and make sure the thing works. Just kidding, Mike. That was just a modest little joke. Should we pull the switch?